Let's get miserable, miserable. I'm not gonna get miserable. Let's get miserable, do you? All right, that's good. Okay, let's see. What else? Midsummer night, and the dreaming's uneasy. Helena's pouting, Bottom's half as and half guy.
Check this one out. Urine down and the whiz. See how much my menstruation is.
Right. You know, you're right. I'm not sure that you're quite ready for that. Don't feel bad. Your heart was in the right place, Farron.
Thanks, Tara.
No problem. I've got your back. We're a team after all.
Hey! Speaking of teams, our first category of the night honors outstanding ensembles and teams.
Nice segue.
And here is a stellar team to present said awards. And to give us a brief history of the Cappies, 2010-2011 Cappies Program Director, Kiss Chris Stendring, and publisher of the Edmonton Journal, John Connolly.
Were celebrated at a gala like this in Washington, D.C. Since then, thousands of talented young performers and writers in cities throughout Canada and the U.S. have participated in a program that for a few brief moments treats them like rock stars. For many, Cappies has opened doors to educational and performing opportunities. For some, it has been a life-altering experience, as you'll read in comments at the back of your programs. Cappies, which stands for Critics and Awards Program, was the brainchild of the late Bill Strauss and theater teacher Judy Bounds. They were seeking a way to celebrate the creativity of young people following the tragedy of Columbine. This is Greater Edmonton's fourth year in the Cappies program, and in that brief time, the program has grown from 60 to 160 critics and over 1,000 students involved on the performing and technical side.